Get ready to match the stars. Richard Paul, Brett Summers, Dick Martin from The Price is Right, Holly Hallstrom, McLean Stevenson, and from Mr. Merlin, Elaine Joyce, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Good group,
huh?
Eh, John?
Yeah, right.
Thank you.
Great group.
Welcome. Welcome to all of you.
Thank you.
Delighted to see all of you here.
Good to be here.
Anything anyone wants to say or plug or do or think about?
Plug?
Yes. McLean
well,
has...
Well, those of you in Sacramento, I have either just done or I'm about to do The Cowardly Lion in The Wizard of Oz.
Oh, wow. Well, look forward to seeing that. This is... going to mystify the heck out of the people who see the show in 1985.
If
now,
we're here.
Let's greet our two players here, John Murray and Kelly Kinnaman. How are you, Kelly?
Fine.
Kelly, as you remember, is spent 3 years in Hawaii, and she's a tour guide. You take groups over there. Is that what you do for a living now?
Well, I arrange groups for them.
You
and
arrange
I'm
groups.
Also a bartender.
And a bartender, right. And John Murray here is a composer and teacher of the piano. Mm-hmm. And what else do you teach? You teach composition?
Yes, and some theory.
Theory?
Yes.
And you play with rock groups?
Yes.
All right, let's get on with it. This is game number two in the middle of round two. And Kelly has one more shot at overtaking John. He has three. That means she needs three to tie and four to win. Milton said, I went to a doctor who was so expensive. For $25, all he did was send me a blank. Doctor, so expensive. $25, all I did was send me a blank. Rimshot. Kelly. Milton said, I went to a doctor who was so expensive. For $25, all he did was send me a blank.
A bill.
Very good. That's wrong. Right?
Well, I knew a doctor in Burbank would send you his nurse for that, but oh, I go to just sends a bill.
There's one for her. Okay, the score is 3-1. What have you got?
What are you doing over there, you bad little boy?
Bill!
Oh, that's 3-2.
Kelly is tied.
Aha! 3-3. For $25, all he did was send me a bill, according to the upper tier. What do you say, lower tier?
Lower tier says Bill.
That wins the game. What do you got, Bill?
Another doctor, Bill.
Antelope. All right. Now, John is not too happy to be leaving here because he won game number one and did very well with a super audience match and has a total of $5,500. Hey, John Murray! Ready?
That's your flower?
What happened to your flower?
It went away.
Oh. All right. Good luck to you, Kelly. We polled the studio audience and said write down your best answer to this. Deserted blank. Deserted blank. Now, you call on three of the six stars for a little assistance here. You think Holly wants to...
Yay, Richard! Oh,
yeah, Richard.
Holly.
Deserted island.
Yeah. All right, one.
Richard.
Deserted beach.
Okay, you've got two. You see, Elaine is hiding. McLean is hiding.
The makings of a very good series, Deserted Children.
Deserted Children.
Love that.
What about Deserted Wife?
All right.
So, yeah, deserted Children,
deserted, deserted
Beach,
alleyway.
And Deserted Island. Now, you want to choose one of those or give us one of your own?
I'm going to go with Holly and say Deserted Island.
That's I go with Holly. Let's see if we have Deserted Island up there. May we see the $100 number, if you please. Wife.
Deserted Wife, yep.
Yeah. They laughed when I sat down to play.
All right, may we see the next one, if you please. Deserted House.
Okay, last one, Deserted Children.
Think it's going to be there, eh? Little
it's
side
there. I'm telling you.
Slide the big one. Deserted Island. Okay. Well, okay. Yeah, $500 means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount of $5,000. But I want you to come back up. Whoops, sorry.
Come on, Gene.
That's
come
a
on.
Different show, Gene.
Out of line.
Wait a minute. Yeah. See, I was trying to get her to turn around.
Yeah, but sure. No, wait a minute. For $500,
she turned the wrong
way. $500, you just can't grab that woman anywhere you want to now. Come on.
It's get your own show, McLean.
He's trying.
Look, he's blushing.
This is okay. Now you grab that peg right there and give it a pull and see if we can double it up for $10,000.
Oh, how are you?
Well, you just slid past Holly there, but you are playing for $5,000, a not inconsiderable sum. Now, if you would, face me.
Watch it.
Smartest thing you ever did, Kelly.
Here we go.
Gene.
Blank Bazaar. B-A-Z-A-A-R. I'll let you read it, Holly. Sam. George.
Blank Bazaar.
Yeah, you just think about it for a minute now. All right, now Holly's ready. Your job is to match her, Kelly. If you do, you get $5,000. What do you say?
Charity Bazaar.
Charity Bazaar. You don't like that? All right. Let's see what Holly has to say about this.
Where does that little girl come from? Where are you from, sweetheart?
Here originally, Kels Mesa.
Oh.
Yeah.
Never went to a bazaar.
But have you ever read the Harper's?
Harper's Bazaar.
Well, let's see now. Kelly, you have a total of $500. Now, that's not bad. Our best wishes to Kelly Kinnaman, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Bye. Now we'll welcome Carmen Shaw and Colleen Myers. Welcome. Nice to have you with us. Colleen, let's find out about you, please.
Hi, Gene. I'm a mother of two children. I'm married to a man right there in the audience.
Who? Raise your hand.
Right there.
There you are. Okay. Just want to know where he is.
I have a three-year-old, Bill, and a one-year-old, Mary Heather.
All right. Where do you live?
San Diego.
Okay. Nice to have you with us, Colleen. Good luck. Carmen, what about you?
I'm from Cosmopolis, Washington, and I've been married 16 and a half years, and I have a 15-year-old. A 12-year-old and a 9-year-old.
Yeah. Somebody says, boy, you've been busy.
What else do you do?
And I enjoy my kids a lot.
You do?
Yes, I do.
Well, I'm very happy for you. Good luck to you, ladies. We'll start this game in a moment or so. Right now, we want to do a little business with America. Here we go. Round one, game one. Colleen, you have a choice of A or B.
B for Bill.
B for Bill. Gary said, the only thing tighter than my budget is Blank's jeans.
I do a better
job. All right, Colleen. Gary said, the only thing tighter than my budget is Blank's jeans.
Brooke Shields.
Brooke Shields. He's the one.
Well, she's wrong. Tighter than Orson Welles. Ah. Those are tight.
Tight.
Very tight.
Boy, I'll say.
Because he's wearing Brooke Shields jeans. That's why they're so tight.
What do you say to that?
Every time I see that commercial with Brooke Shields, I think, I'll bet those split during one of those takes, and those cameramen got the best view of Mecca in the whole world. Brooke Shields.
Aha. Yes.
Brooke Shields.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, what a surprise.
Well, I guess she does one of the biggest commercials, doesn't she? I mean, there are several, but hers is quite popular. The only thing tighter than my budget is Brooke Shields' jeans, according to Carmen. What do you say?
Well, the only thing coming between me and Colleen's answer is Brooks.
Pretty close, right?
Very close. Incidentally, you just called Colleen, I think, Carmen. Doesn't make any difference, but Colleen's pretty upset.
Oh, yeah.
I don't have any idea whose jeans are tighter than whose, but I cheated and copied her answer, so I wrote both.
I'm surprised at you. I thought by now you would have done a jean survey.
No, no.
No?
No. No, I've,
Settled down.
For antelope.
Mm. Oh, look, the people that just tuned in aren't going to know what you mean when I say it. She wore an antelope outfit, sports fans, the other day. It consisted of two pheasant feathers and a leather strap. And was a little distracting. But you looked lovely today in the basketball shirt and white coat.
Sure. It's a basketball
sure,
shirt and
but
a white
that
coat.
Is not a basketball shirt.
That is.
It's a basketball shirt.
It's a basketball shirt.
Oh, I do like that.
Go, go, go.
No.
More!
I think I deserve a little applause because it was my idea.
No, no, no. Take it off.
No.
Give her your sweater.
No. I just recently had my entire body capped and don't dare to list stitches here.
Elaine, would you like to respond to this? Gary said the only thing tighter than my budget is Blank's jeans.
John Travolta's.
Uh-huh.
Ah.
Got a cute Blank, too. Now, Carmen, it's your turn.
Yes.
You're ready. For us, we're ready for you. Some things just don't make sense. Like Captain Hook becoming a blank.
Hurry up, Hans.
Did this fix you? What did you think?
Can I have a t-shirt?
She wants a t-shirt too.
Oh, the t-shirt. Can I have the body?
How do you respond to something like that?
I sold her that for $16.95. You ready over here?
So I'm right. Not quite ready.
Okay. All right, Carmen. Some things just don't make sense, like Captain Hook becoming a blank.
Basketball player?
Basketball player.
Now, I do have to show the answer that I wrote down first before I gave it some thought.
Before Richard's...
Oh, no, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
You don't mind if I run the show, do you?
Pretend I'm not here.
Well, he always answers. Come over to all through the week you've been coming to me.
Yeah. Just ignore me. Just pretend. I know I haven't made a big impression on you. No, I just went with the idea that he was bad, see? So I said he wouldn't become a nun.
Oh. You paid no attention to the hat that he had a hook for a hand.
Well, no, I didn't.
Now.
See, now first I said, and I...
Not 20 minutes, just...
No, just first I said, Captain Hook becoming a lieutenant. And then I realized that was just plain nonsense. So I said, no, gynecologist. That's a doctor.
You had to be there? Oh, okay.
I'm in great
All right.
pain. I don't know if anyone
That's
else
disgusting. Is. A proctologist.
Oh! Woo! When you go home, look up that word in the dictionary. Holly, some things don't make sense, like Captain Hook becoming a...
Well, initially, I went with doctor. I was following along the same lines, only far more...
conservative, right.
Yes, because there is Dr. Hook, you know, the group, Dr. Hook. But then I just thought, wouldn't it be silly if he was a diamond cutter?
Right. It would be very difficult to hold a diamond
not
with your
funny,
hook.
Not funny, but difficult.
Yeah. What do you say, McClain?
I'm not going to go for anything zany and try to top that. So I just said surgeon.
A surgeon.
I guess that one.
All right. Elaine...
And I said, traffic cop.
A traffic cop. No one said my answer.
What was that?
Your answer?
Juggler.
Oh,
juggler.
Great.
That's good.
Juggler
a dealer in Vegas.
Right. A dealer in Vegas. Right.
A palm right. reader.
A hooker.
Four to nothing to score. Round two coming up in a moment or so. Now this for you.
Our show, Mr. Gene River. Hello there.
Now, we go to round two. Colleen, you're ahead. You go first. A it is for Colleen. Hey, have you heard that James Garner is starring in a new series?
No.
Oh, want to hear about it?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's called The Blank Files.
What?
Oh, I saw. I left out half the question. Have you heard that James Garner... Cut the music. I got to do this all over again. Look, have you heard that James Garner is starring in a new series about salads?
Oh.
Salads.
About salads. It's called The Blank Files.
We don't write.
Only two people play.
Wait till you're not
here. Not quite as clever.
That's all there is.
All right, Colleen. Have you heard that James Garner is starring in a new series about salads? It's called The Blank Files.
Well, Gene, I majored in home ec, so I have to go with the recipe files.
Did she say? Do you remember the name of the show that he did for a long time?
Rockford Files.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. This is a new TV series about salads.
Mm-hmm.
And your answer is the recipe files?
Right.
Okay.
The blue cheese files.
Richard, what do you say?
Rockford.
The Rockford files.
At last, finally.
Show us your cheese.
We know how to make you feel bad on this show, Colleen.
Sure
here
do.
It comes, Rockford.
Oh.
Sorry.
All right, Carmen, that means you need four to tie and five to win. The fisherman said the oil slick around here is so bad. It's so bad you can get gasoline just by blanking a fish.
You can get gasoline?
Yes.
Trust me. Ba-ba, ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba.
The fisherman said the oil slick around here is so bad, you can get gasoline just by blanking a fish.
Squeezing a fish?
Squeezing a fish is good.
Oh.
Very good.
This may be a match.
Or
take
maybe...
Take a fish, an albacore, you throw it over your shoulder, and you pat its little back, and it burps.
Really?
But you kind of squeeze it and pat
no,
it.
No, that
you...
ain't squeezing. No. That's Boy, not a real
are you
squeeze.
Reaching.
Oh, boy.
I came here ill, bad case of the flu, dying on the vine. But I did say squeezing.
All right. So, 4-1 is the score.
What Dick said.
I think squeezing fish is just a smidgen kinky.
Did I ever say I wasn't kinky?
Scaling fish.
Scaling.
But I wouldn't squeeze one.
You never really tried squeezing a fish?
No, I have.
I think you'll enjoy it once you try it. Just try it once for me, would you?
Any kind?
Yeah.
A nice little sand dab?
A sand dab would be good. Striped sea bass.
Oh.
A baby striped
just
sea bass.
Just squeeze it, huh?
Just squeeze it a little bit.
Should you be alone? Should
yeah.
be music?
No, you'd be alone.
A little candlelight. Candlelight. Or
candlelight
light,
right?
Squeeze
That's
the fish.
You'll love it.
Okay.
Holly, have we aroused you?
I'm not going to say anything.
All right.
Although it's just like right here, you know?
You can get gasoline just by blanking a fish.
This is very popular. Very popular. All the fabulous people are doing it on the coastal towns. It's fish squeezing.
Yay! All right. 4-2 score. McLean, what do you say to this?
Okay, now before our fearless producer blows his honker over there on this.
Yeah.
I'd like for him to give this careful consideration, because to me, to pump a fish is to squeeze a fish.
So that means Colleen wins the game. What did Elaine have? Pumping. All right, come on down. I got the blue dot, if you would, please. That time I'm going to spin you off, but just temporarily. You'll be back for game number two later. Right now, we have this message for America. Hello. And goodbye. You were all splendid again, as usual.
And so soon?
So soon.
Oh,
you know,
time flies when you're having
But you'll have
fun.
One more shot at it tomorrow.
Thank you. I'm going home and squeeze some fish myself.
Good.
I'm
going to
get my hat and go with you.
Remember the candles. Candlelight. It's perfect.
That's right.
I'm Gene Rayburn, hoping you all join us here tomorrow for the match game. Thank you. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive 4 gallons of super scrubbable TruTest Easy Carry Latex Flat Wall and Trim Finish, perfect with walls and woodwork, sold only by True Value Hardware Stores nationwide. And fresh Listerine. Listerine is strong to give you clean breath in last hours. Listerine antiseptic kills the germs that can cause bad breath. And from Hartz Mountain, gifts for your dog or cat, including the Hartz 2-in-1 Plus collar that kills ticks and fleas for up to 5 months. And Step Saver, ideal for no wax floors, too, because it cleans without dulling, shines without buildup. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. The program was edited for broadcast.